नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज टेम्पल टाउन्स एंड पिलग्रिमेज सेंटर. रिलीजन हैज़ बीन एन इंटीग्रल पार्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइफ सिंस द बिगनिंग. द मिडिवल पीरियड सॉ द एमर्जेंस ऑफ अ नंबर ऑफ टेम्पल टाउन्स एंड पिलग्रिमेज सेंटर्स सच एज तिरुपति, सोमनाथ, मदुराई, अजमेर, बनारस, मथुरा एंड नासिक. सो द रिलीजन प्लेज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन आवर लाइफ सिंस द बिगिनिंग वेन द लाइफ एग्जिस्ट. So during the medieval period also different types of temple towns and pilgrimage centers have evolved. They are the Tirupati, Somnath, Madurai, Ajmer, Banaras, Mathura and Nasik. Remember it, it is very important. Temple towns were centered around large temples. That is, activities of the temple shape the economy and society of the town. So the temple towns plays an important role, and it was at the center of the or you can say around the large temples where different types of activities which were performed in the temples, it shaped the economy and the society of that particular town. A variety of people congregated around temples to participate in trade, agriculture, banking and craft production, which were organized and promoted by the temples. So in the you can say temple itself, different types of people, they used to work around the temples so that they can participate in the business, or they can perform the agriculture activity, banking or craft activity, okay, and due to which they can organize and promote the temples. Thus pilgrimage centers receive regular patronage from devotees, pilgrims and rulers, all of whom contributed to their rapid growth. So because of these devotees, pilgrims and ruler, they used to regularly give the you can say fund or you can say different types of items. So different types of item, due to which there was a rapid growth of temple towns. Banaras emerged as one of the most important pilgrimage center in the Indian subcontinent. So at present Banaras is the most important pilgrimage center, and because of these different types of peoples who are residing over there, they keeps on giving different types of funds in order to increase their rapid growth. Centers of trade and commerce. The growth of trade and commerce proved to be a major driving force for the emergence of urban cities. So the growth of the trade and commerce plays an important role in order to develop the whole urban centers. Trade relation existed within India as well as with the external world. So the trade relation was not only inside the India but also the we can say external world too. Indian merchants exchanged surplus goods such as spices, teas, silk, textile, semi-precious stone and other merchandise that were in great demand in other countries and within various region of India. So what are the different types of items which were you can say produced in India, and later on these surplus goods were transferred or exported to the different types of or you can say in the different parts of the world in order to increase the trade system. They were the spices, tea, silk, textile, semi-precious stone and other type of clothes or items. Market street called hat or large retail market called mandis existed in towns and large villages. So the market street, they were basically known as hat, and a large retail market, they were known as mandis. Certain towns like Banaras, Kanchipuram and Pulikat became important textile and craft center. So these are the three important you can say towns which became the important textile center and craft center in India. Settlement of merchants and traders in a particular region and the connectivity of a town with neighboring areas and towns also contributed to the process of urbanization. So with the help of the settlement of merchants and traders in different types of the region in India and due to the connectivity of the various town with the neighboring areas and town, it increased the process of urbanization. At times, merchants and traders travel from one town to another to buy local articles and sell products from distant places. So different types of, you can say, merchants and trader travelers. They used to move from one town to the another in order to buy local articles and sell products from distant places. Traders travel long distance with their goods in big group called caravan. So the trader travelers, they in order to travel for a long distance, they travel in a group with their goods. They were known as caravans. Therefore, the place where they halted to rest and recoup were called caravan series. So the place where they used to rest, okay, because they are traveling from for a very long distance, so obviously they need rest, right? So the place where they rest, they were known as caravan series. Merchant trader with Southeast Asia, Europe, Africa and Arabia. So the merchants used to trade with the Southeast Asia, Europe, Africa and Arabia. As a result of the discovery of trade routes, a number of trading settlements such as Surat, Musilipatnam, Patna, Dhaka, Agra and Lahore became important. Okay, so due to the discovery of trade routes, a number of trading settlements were settled in the Surat, Musilipatnam, Patna, Dhaka, Agra and Lahore, and they became the most important part for the trading or to doing business. These are located at the intersection of important trade routes. So they were located at a certain place, or you can say, at a different places where they were connected by the, trade routes, where they can go from one place to the another in order to do the business.